I am Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. Headaches, everybody gets them, but more than 45 million Americans suffer from chronic recurring headaches. And while headaches are common, frequent headaches are not normal. Here to talk about the different types of headaches, how to diagnose and treat them, is Dr. Emily Rubenstein Engel. She is a neurologist with the Scripps Clinic Medical Group. She is the director of the D'Alessio Headache Center at Scripps Clinic. Doctor, thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me, Susan.
So let's talk about one of the toughest headaches is migraines.
Yeah, you're right, Susan, but you might be surprised to know it's also very common. About 20% of the population has migraine, and it's frequently misdiagnosed and underdiagnosed.
And why is that?
Because of the anatomy of migraine, patients will often feel their migraine headaches behind their eye, in their sinus, down by the teeth. And unfortunately, they're told, go to the eye doctor. It's a sinus headache. Go to the dentist. It's TMJ. But it's actually migraine. And that's because of the anatomy of migraine, which is actually quite interesting. So when you have migraine, the trigeminal system, which is deep in the brainstem, is hyperactive. And this then activates the trigeminal nerves that come out behind the eye to the sinus area and down to the teeth. And that's why patients are told, go to the eye doctor. It's coming from your sinuses. It's coming from your teeth. You're too stressed. It's coming from your neck. It's none of that. It's migraine, which is remarkably common.
And how do you treat the migraine?
It's very treatable. You should not be suffering. If you have migraine, you should not despair or feel that you're alone. It's a very manageable problem. There are some lifestyle changes that can be addressed and some very good, effective medications that work very well.
And what about the role of hormones in migraines?
Hormones are huge in migraine. So migraine often starts in puberty. In women, it starts when they get their period. And in young women, they frequently will get a migraine headache with their period. What I see significantly in my practice is perimenopausal women whose hormones are really fluctuating a lot, who have a significant worsening of their migraines during this period.
And then what about lifestyle changes to help decrease the frequency of the migraine?
That's a great question because patients often want natural treatments for their migraines, and looking at your lifestyle is one of the best ways to treat this naturally. So it's important that you minimize the change in your life. So go to sleep at the same time, wake up at the same time, have your meals at the same time. Changes in routine are a big trigger, especially sleeping in. I tell my migraine patients, you can sleep in for about an hour on the weekends, but anything more than that, you're almost guaranteed to wake up with a migraine.
And how do you treat migraines?
We treat them in addition to looking at lifestyle factors with medications. And there are some very effective medications. If patients have frequent headache days, we put them on a preventive medication, which is often something that they take every day. And if they have relatively infrequent headaches, we give them an effective as needed medication.
And then what about a chronic daily headache? What's the cause of that? And what's the treatment?
The most common cause of chronic daily headache is migraine. So patients who do not receive proper treatment for their migraines, over time, the headaches escalate so that they begin to have more and more headache days. And often they mistakenly take too many pain medications, which actually can cause something called rebound headache.
And then what's a cluster headache?
Cluster headache is much less common than migraine. It's about 1/100th of the frequency of migraine. It more commonly happens in men, but occasionally it can happen in women too. The biggest clinical distinction between cluster and migraine is when you have a bad migraine, you want to lie down in a dark room. When you have a bad cluster headache, you can't stay still. Patients with cluster are banging their head against the wall.
And how do you treat that?
That's also very treatable. We actually can treat cluster with oxygen, which is very interesting. Patients will put on an oxygen face mask and it makes the headache go away. If that doesn't work, then we use medications similar to migraine medications, which often work.
And what about the headache that's caused by medication?
That's also known as rebound headache, and that happens from taking too many pain medication. Even the over-the-counters can do this. So you really shouldn't be treating more than about twice a week. If you find that you're having to treat more than twice a week, you should talk to your doctor about better, more effective treatments.
And then what about a tension headache? What is that and what triggers it?
So a tension headache is not bad enough to bring you to the doctor. It's usually a mild, annoying headache that goes away with over-the-counters.
And what causes the tension headache?
Some of us actually think that it's a mild migraine. Other physicians feel that it's related to muscle spasm, releasing inflammatory chemicals. It's potentially a combination of the two, but it's benign, it's not dangerous. And a very interesting study showed that the very act of a patient going to their doctor saying, I'm having a headache, makes it not tension.
Really?
Because tension headache is not bad enough to take you to the doctor. If you're going to the doctor, it's almost always migraine.
So how do you treat a tension headache?
With over-the-counters. Sometimes with a preventive if it's happening frequently.
So it wouldn't be something like ice on your forehead or heat on the forehead or on
you
the...
You could try something like that, sure. Yeah.
Ice or heat?
Depending on what makes you feel better. There's no right answer there.
And then what about a sleep-related headache?
If you have sleep apnea, that can cause you to wake up with a headache. So other signs of sleep apnea are snoring, having a big, thick neck that potentially is closing off your airway. So if your sleep partner complains of snoring and you're waking up with headaches, you should talk to your doctor about maybe getting a sleep study.
So how do you assess somebody who has a headache?
We see them in the office, we take a thorough history, and we do a neurological examination. If your neurological examination is normal, you typically don't need a CAT scan or an MRI. If there's something concerning in your story, though, then we'll sometimes order imaging.
And then talk about the different treatments for headaches.
The big picture is either as needed medicines or preventive medications. So in the past, preventive medications were a pill that you would have to take every day to decrease the frequency of your headaches. These days, we have other preventives that you don't necessarily have to take every day. Or Botox is also a terrific preventive medication that's injections that you take every 3 months.
And then what about biofeedback and acupuncture and lifestyle changes?
So biofeedback and acupuncture can be helpful for some patients. I'm pretty impressed with lifestyle changes. And as we talked about earlier, making sure that you go to sleep at the same time, wake up at the same time, manage your stress, and don't go hungry. There is a real myth about food being a trigger, whereas it's actually more common that going hungry is the trigger.
And what is an occipital nerve block?
Occipital nerve blocks are one of the treatments that we do in the office to treat either a migraine headache that hasn't gone away with more typical treatments, or we also use it for a less common headache type, which is called occipital neuralgia.
And what is that?
It's where the occipital nerve that comes out the back of the head gets pinched by arthritis, and patients feel the pain coming forward to behind the eye, but it's different from a migraine type pain. It's sharp and stabbing.
Are there ways to prevent a headache?
Yes, taking care of yourself. So making sure that you don't skip meals, making sure that you're not dehydrated, making sure that you're getting good sleep, regular hours of sleep, and doing what you can to moderate your stress. But let me emphasize, it's not a psychological condition. Migraine in particular is a neurological condition, and that's why we treat it in neurology.
So people get headaches all the time, but when should they go see a doctor?
If you're having headache all the time, you should go see a doctor. It's not normal to have headache all the time. Having one or two headache days a month is okay. And if you have a good treatment regimen, you don't have to see your doctor. But if you feel like you're always having a headache and no matter what you do, it's not going away, see your doctor. Also, if you infrequently have headaches that are disabling and that you don't have a good treatment for, you should see your doctor for that too. It's important to keep in mind that headache, in particular migraine, is a very treatable condition.
Any final thoughts, Doctor?
That we're always happy to see patients in our clinic here because we feel we have a nice team and we really make our patients feel better.
Doctor, thanks so much for being with us. We appreciate you taking the time.
It was my pleasure, Susan. Thank you for inviting me.
If you'd like more information on how to diagnose and treat headaches, just click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media at Scripps Health. At Scripps, we're here for good. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks for joining us.